Hello and welcome to this screencast for WJEC ICT at GCSE level. This screencast supports mobile phones for the home entertainment section of Unit 1. Okay, mobile phones. What do they involve? Well, mobile phones started off quite simple. You could ring people and you could send them a text message. So they've been around a while, mobile phones, but they've grown and they've grown and they've grown in usage, and they've started becoming much more popular and bigger than they ever used to be, and their most important functionality has grown beyond just phoning people. So obviously you can contact people by phone, text message, multimedia messaging services. You can access the internet on the move now. They're now satellite navigation devices. A lot of them are now cashless payment systems, so you can pay for things via your mobile phone in shops, like the Oyster cards in London where you just swipe your card at the tubes. Gaming, big part of, for example, smartphones is gaming. And also you've got entertainment as well, so videos and MP3s all can be done and accessed via a mobile phone nowadays. They're just a few features. If you were to really look deeply at a mobile phone, you would see all the things that it can do. And these are just a few. There are loads and loads of things out there. You know, calculators, phones, web browsers, Bluetooth, transferring files, downloadable apps to extend the use of your phone so you can download extra games, push services, smartphones, speaker phones, all sorts of different phones and things out there today, the features that they can do. Looking in the top corner though, in the right, this is the newest kind of thing by LG though, where you can have a phone which is on your wrist. So they've become so developed that, you know, they are making way for a really revolutionized use of mobile phones. There are lots of things that phones can do, becoming quite a useful feature, a useful device for lots of people. And a phone that with all these features are actually called smartphones. So what are the advantages of a phone then? Well, there's lots of different advantages for mobile phone services these days. They become smaller for a start, much smaller, much lighter, making them portable. You can take your contact list with you, no need to memorise phone numbers, and they go wherever you go. And the battery life isn't bad as well on phones nowadays. You can make calls, contact people anywhere, and generally, signal strength is quite good wherever you go. Multifunction, meaning that, for example, my phone is an MP3 player, it's satellite navigation, it's a web browser, and I can watch videos, and it's a phone all at the same time. I can communicate worldwide, and what astounds me is you can go outside, you can go to somewhere like a supermarket, and you can buy a phone, a simple phone with loads of different functions, for a fiver. That's brilliant. Call prices are reasonable, they are getting cheaper today, cheaper and cheaper every day. But the most important thing is, phones are becoming faster and they're becoming smaller. There are downsides though. Calls themselves can be costly, especially internationally, 30, 40, 50, 60, even 70 pence a minute in some cases. If you take out a contract phone, you're tied to that contract for 12, 18 or 24 months, which can be quite expensive. Phones, unfortunately, because they are getting smaller, can be lost or stolen. And that's a bad thing, I'm afraid. And if there's no password or anything on the device, you leave your phone around, someone can very easily pick it up, read your messages, read your texts, ring people, all those kinds of things. Some parts of the world, signals are a problem, especially in like countryside areas, you might lose a signal. And if you're going to really fully use your device, for example, I could watch a film on mine, I could listen to a bit of music, make a phone call. If I actually did all that, I know I can, but if I actually did do all that, my battery on my phone's only going to last 2 or 3 hours, which isn't brilliant. You know, yes, I can communicate with people more and more by text or using a social network through my phone, but again, as said in previous screencasts, that leads to further social interaction problems. You're communicating more digitally and less actually in person. And at work, at school, you know what I mean, phones can become more of a distraction to work as well, so people use it as a social device. And unfortunately as well, More and more people are using them to cyberbully, sending inappropriate text messages, prank calls, Bluetoothing pictures of embarrassing pictures of people to other people and videoing them and happy slapping and all those kinds of things, which makes them quite a scary technology, really. Obviously, they can be used for fraud as well, prank calls, other things that a phone gets used for. So, that was a very, very, very quick look at mobile phone technology. Hope you found that useful. Thank you very much. My name is Chris Coleman.